In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the regulation of enzyme activity in a living system. We know that enzymes are required for increasing the speed of chemical reaction. Now, what happens in the living system? This increased speed of chemical reaction is not required at all the time. Rather, under certain condition or under certain time, this living system needs to increase some chemical reaction, whereas decrease some other chemical reaction. That means our living system needs to regulate this enzyme activity. And those mechanism, that is regulation of enzyme activity, that we are going to discuss. Now, in a living system, there are two major types of enzyme regulation. In the first type, regulation occur by change in the activity of existing enzyme. So first is the regulation by change in activity of existing enzyme. See, this existing word is very important in this condition. See, what happens in our body, there are various enzymes, right? And most of the enzymes are protein in nature. So what happens, our living system or our body, it modifies this structure of enzyme or carries out certain work on the enzyme, and so enzyme's activity might increase or decrease. So all that mechanism which does this, which works on the existing enzyme, that will fall under this category. Whereas in the second type of enzyme regulation, it occurs by change in the concentration of enzymes. Okay, so second type is the regulation by change in enzyme concentration. Now, how this change in enzyme concentration occur? We know that as enzymes are protein, and protein gets synthesized based on the information on the DNA. So in our cell's nucleus, there is a DNA, right? And on this DNA, there are certain specialized part which are called as a gene. This gene undergo transcription and then translation to give rise to enzymes, and there are separate genes for separate enzymes. Now this enzymes work, and its work is finished, this enzyme undergo wear and tear, and this enzymes, once their work is done, they undergo degradation. So what happens in the living system, there are certain mechanism which can modulate, that means increase or decrease synthesis, or there may be a mechanism which can increase or decrease this degradation. So if the synthesis and degradation are affected, that means enzyme's concentration is affected. So whatever mechanism which modulate synthesis or modulate degradation, they will fall under this category, right? So now let's enlist all the mechanism which falls under this both category. First, we'll enlist the condition in which regulation occur by change in activity of existing enzyme. But before we discuss that, remember, as there is a already synthesized enzyme and we are just modifying its activity, this type of regulation is going to be rapid. So rapidly enzyme can be stimulated, as well as rapidly that enzyme can be inhibited. So rapid in nature leads to only short term regulation. Whereas in this case, that by change in the enzyme concentration, as I told you, there is a change in synthesis or change in degradation. And this change in synthesis and change in degradation, they are a slow process. So this regulation is going to be slow. So what will happen? The enzyme stimulation will be slow, as well as enzyme's inhibition will be slow, right? And because of that, this is going to be a long-term regulation. Now, under the heading of regulation by change in activity of existing enzyme, there are several mechanisms. The first and the most important for your exam is the allosteric regulation. And under the heading of allosteric regulation, there is one very special type of regulation, that is feedback inhibition. The second type is the covalent modification of enzyme. The third one is the proteolytic cleavage, or you can say proteolytic activation of enzyme. The next one is the compartmentalization compartmentalization. The next one is the cascade mechanism. And the last one is the protein-protein interactions. Protein-protein interactions. Now, these six mechanisms, they fall under this regulation by change in the activity of existing enzyme. In this type, in the second type, that is regulation by change in enzyme concentration, what mechanism will be under this heading? Let's try to understand. See, for the synthesis to get modulated for increasing synthesis or decreasing synthesis, what needs to be done? This gene which encodes for this particular enzyme, if these genes are stimulated, then obviously enzyme concentration will increase. And the stimulation of gene is called as a gene induction, right? If genes are induced, then enzyme concentration will also be increased. So this regulation is called as an enzyme induction. Enzyme induction. What does it mean? It means the gene which is responsible for the synthesis of enzyme is stimulated. The reverse mechanism, the gene which is responsible for this enzyme synthesis, if it is inhibited, it is called as a repression. Okay, so when gene repression occurs, enzyme concentration is decreased. And this type of regulation is called as an enzyme repression. Now, what about degradation? This degradation is not just a random process. Rather, enzyme degradation is also a highly regulated process. Okay, so if there is this regulation of enzyme degradation is affected, that can also lead to change in the concentration of enzyme. So that we can call it as a regulation of enzyme degradation. So these are all the mechanism by which enzyme activity can be regulated. We will talk about all these various mechanisms of enzyme regulation in a subsequent video in a great depth. I hope that in this video, whatever we have discussed is clear to you. If you have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.